We are, as we've been saying, just a day away from the spectacle in the sky. Tomorrow's total eclipse that's going to stretch across the country, the first one visible in the continental U.S. in 38 years. It's exciting for everybody, from casual viewers to hardcore scientists. So let's bring in Lucianne Walkowicz, the chair of the astrobiology at the Library of Congress. Good morning to you.
Good morning.
So there's been all this talk about the need for special glasses, but you say that a Ritz cracker, and I have one here, I have a little jar of them here, a Ritz cracker will do the trick?
Anything with a tiny hole in it will do the trick. So even if you have no chance to get to those special eclipse glasses, you'll still be able to project an image of the sun. So you can use just a sheet of paper with a hole in it. You can use a cracker so you can eat it later. Or you can even look for the sun streaming through trees. That's actually my personal favorite, is that anywhere that you'd have dappled sunlight, those little tiny holes between the leaves will project hundreds of images of the crescent sun while it's in eclipse.
Nice. And what can scientists learn from an eclipse?
Well, you know, for scientists who study the sun, one of the challenges is that that central disk of the sun is really bright, and it makes it very difficult to see the outer layers of the sun, or the corona, this hot outer extended region that we'll all be able to see during the total eclipse. So in the case of an eclipse, the moon actually does a very perfect job of blocking out that bright light so we can study the outer layers. And the reason that you'd want to do that is that that creates what we call space weather. So streams of radiation and particles that can impact us here on Earth and affect our power grid, our communication satellites, etc.
Excellent. I was going to ask you something about animal behavior and whether I should be watching my cats during the course of this eclipse, but apparently the answer is no. So thank you very much for coming on this morning. Really appreciate it, and so do the people at Ritz Cracker. And don't miss our team coverage of the Great American Eclipse starting tomorrow at 1, as Paula puts one in my face, right here on ABC. And don't forget to send us your photos or videos.
Well, hey there, GMA fans. Robin Roberts here. Thanks for checking out our YouTube channel. Lots of great stuff here. So go on, click the subscribe button right over here to get more of awesome videos and content from GMA every day, anytime. We thank you for watching, and we'll see you in the morning on GMA.